What's going on, guys? Tyler here from DontPanicDoThis.com, the site all about helping you to beat your panic attacks and anxiety. Now, today I want to talk to you guys a little bit about a plant called kava. If you're anything like me, you might have not heard of kava before, but it's a really cool plant with anti-anxiety properties, so it can be really effective for helping people with panic attacks to manage those symptoms of anxiety. Like I said, a lot of people might not have heard of this plant before, so I want to really explain exactly what it is, where you can get it, how it can help you, and talk a little bit about my first experience using kava and how I felt it helped me with my symptoms of anxiety. So let's get right into that. Now, I understand a lot of you guys probably haven't heard of kava before. That's mostly because it hasn't really gained popularity in countries like the United States until pretty recently. Traditionally, kava has been consumed in Polynesian and Pacific Island cultures as a sort of ritual drink that they would consume, sort of like alcohol. So the way that kava works is, kava is a plant, and they'll harvest that plant and take the roots, grind up the roots, and then the roots are strained through a strainer, much like coffee with coffee grinds, and it creates this sort of muddy water, slurry mixture type stuff with this real earthy taste that most people aren't such a fan of. But the drink, then you end up with this drink that sort of has, it's sort of like a parallel to alcohol almost. It doesn't work in the same way at all, but it does have similar effects in the sense that it's gonna lower your anxiety and just make you feel a little bit more euphoric and even intoxicated. So it's sort of like a natural version of alcohol, but not quite, because it's you know, a completely different drink. But yeah, that's the gist of what kava is. It's this natural drink that's going to get you a little bit intoxicated, lower your anxiety a little bit, make you feel just a little bit more euphoric. The way I discovered kava was actually just walking down the street. I was staying in a random city, I think Fort Lauderdale in Florida at the time, and I was just walking down the street and saw a bar with the neon sign outside that said kava bar. So I said, okay, that's weird. I know what a bar is. I don't know what a kava bar is. I like bars. Let me try out this kava bar. So I just walked in having really no idea what to expect, sat down at the bar, and the bartender there explained to me what kava is. It's this natural plant-based drink similar to alcohol with an intoxicating effect. I said, kind of strange that there's some plant that intoxicates you that's being legally served at a bar, because I'm thinking like hallucinogens and stuff. But anyway, I thought, kind of strange, but it sounds fun. Let me give it a shot. Sit down at the bar. The guy brings out a half shell coconut with this muddy water type stuff in it, and a sort of like a pineapple on the side, I guess, as a chaser. Anyway, I order a couple of drinks like that. For each of them, there's a ritual where you're supposed to, I believe, I might be getting this wrong, but I believe you say bula, take the drink, you drink it all at once. It's like a shot because it doesn't taste that good. It's, in my opinion, I'd much rather drink kava than a shot, because a shot, like, you know, it's got that burning feeling taste that makes you kind of want to throw up. Kava just has this like earthy, muddy taste, which is, it's not good, but it's also not intolerable. It's not something that you're going to have like a, I don't think most people will have this like, just want to spit it out taste. It's not great, but it's okay. It's like muddy water. Anyway, you throw it all back so you don't have to like sip on it. And I take a couple of shots like that. I guess you'd call them shots. It's like half a shell worth of coconut. You just drink it as fast as you can. But I take a couple like that because, as the bartender explained to me, kava does have something called a reverse tolerance, which means that people who have been drinking kava for longer periods of time will actually feel the effects faster. So it's a reverse tolerance, unlike alcohol, where the more you drink, the more it takes to reach that same level of intoxication. Kava apparently has a reverse tolerance where people drinking it for the first time won't get the full effect. So I had, a couple of drinks to try to achieve those same effects. And then after that, I just was walking down the street listening to music. And I guess I would just best describe it as like a mild, buzzy, euphoric feeling. It felt, I wasn't wasted or anything like that. It felt somewhere like having a mild alcohol buzz combined with a mild marijuana buzz. It was like somewhere in between there. It was like a high and a buzz, but it was pleasant. It wasn't like an overwhelming feeling. It wasn't like I was out of control. It was just this kind of pleasant, slightly euphoric, perhaps less inhibited, less anxious type feeling for me. Typically speaking, the benefits of kava include decreased stress and anxiety, increased relaxation, anti-inflammatory properties, it's an effective sleep aid, and it has anesthetic properties. So that's what most people can probably expect to achieve from taking some kava. Later on, I would go home and do some research and find out exactly how kava works. And the way that it works is it has active ingredients called kava lactones. These kava lactones include kavain, yangonin, and desmethoxyangonin. I had to read those because they're hard to pronounce. But those kava lactones are responsible for the anti-anxiety and euphoric effects that make kava so popular. Kavain works as a muscle relaxant, helping people to relieve tension in their body. When the body relaxes, the mind relaxes, and that makes kava an effective anti-anxiety sort of supplement. Desmethoxyangonin works by increasing dopamine in the brain. Since dopamine is one of the feel-good chemicals in the brain, this is responsible for kava's euphoric effects. And then yangonin, another kava lactone, tends to bind to the cannabinoid receptor CB1. This might contribute to the anti-anxiety effects or that buzz that kava can cause, and that actually kind of explains a little bit of why, maybe that explains why I kind of feel like a little bit of a marijuana buzz when I take it, but without the paranoia and anxiety that smoking marijuana can cause for a lot of people. Now, for anyone looking to try kava for the first time, the recommended dosage for an effective dose of kava is about 75 to 200, 250 milligrams of kava lactone. Kava is measured in kava lactone content. You don't want to exceed more than 250, otherwise you're going to be more likely to have negative side effects. Those are things like headaches, dizziness, nausea, stuff like that. Not too much unlike just being intoxicated on alcohol. Just unpleasant effects that you're going to want to avoid. So definitely make sure you're not over consuming kava. Now, it might be a little bit difficult to measure kava lactone content, especially if you're just sitting at a kava bar. You know, I don't know how you would know how many milligrams of kava lactone are in there. My recommendation would just be to take it slow. Take advice from the bartender, take it slow, and just gradually see what you can handle without it giving you any adverse side effects or anything like that. Like I said, my first time, I had no idea what to expect, but I had a drink, waited a couple minutes, felt fine, had another, waited a couple minutes, felt fine, had another, and that's kind of how I found my sweet spot and was like, okay, a couple of drinks and I'm feeling the effects of kava pretty effectively. I don't need more than this, and this is sort of a sweet spot for me. So for your first time, whether you're trying it at a bar or whether you've ordered kava on your own from online or bought it somewhere else, like I said, just, you don't want to exceed 250 milligrams of kava lactone. However, just take it slow and see where your sweet spot is. Don't rush it. It's just like alcohol. No one can really tell you exactly how much is right for you. Just go with your comfort level. I did briefly mention earlier that kava has something that people claim to call a reverse tolerance, meaning people who are drinking it for the first time might require a little bit more kava in order to achieve the same effect as regular kava drinkers. I don't think people know exactly why this is. I don't know exactly why that is. It might have something to do with the kava lactones just building up in your body or something along those lines. Whatever the case, just keep that in mind that if you're giving kava a try for the first time, I mean, I even remember being a kid and there was this rumor that, I still don't to this day know if this is true, but I remember there was that rumor that like the first time you smoke weed, you don't get high. That's like a pretty common myth, but I don't even know if it's really true because, I mean, people could be smoking the wrong way, not inhaling, stuff like that. It's kind of one of those things that are tough to gauge, but I think kava's sort of the same way. Like, I don't know if this is a myth. I don't know if it's a real thing. Enough people say it's a real thing for me to believe it is a real thing. So just keep that in mind. Kava's reverse tolerance. The first time you're drinking kava, you might need a little bit more than a regular kava drinker. But if you don't get those effects, those anti-anxiety, euphoric, intoxicating, pleasant effects that kava is known for, I wouldn't dismiss it right away. A lot of people don't even get the intended effects of kava until their fifth or sixth time trying kava. My recommendation would be to give it a couple of chances. As long as you don't have any terrible reaction, allergic reaction or anything like that to it, give it a couple of tries, five or six tries, and see if you eventually start to get those effects that kava is known for, those anti-anxiety effects. Give it a few chances. So with anything new you're putting in your body, your question probably is always gonna be, is this product safe? So is kava safe? I think that's a great question. And it's something that's been pretty controversial in the past. Some countries have actually banned kava in the past due to claims, some sort of anecdotal experience with certain people having liver damage or even liver failure from kava use. looking at these findings and these specific cases, it sort of seemed like there's not really, this is my opinion, it doesn't seem to me like there is good evidence that kava actually is harmful to the liver. It doesn't seem, you know, it seems like maybe these occasional occurrences of it happening could have something to do with a bad supplier who's using the incorrect parts of the plants, like the leaf and stems as opposed to the roots, or just a supplier who has a high level of heavy metals in the actual supplement powder that's selling them, or something like that, due to it not being that well regulated in certain places or something like that. So I don't personally, from what I've read online, I don't believe that those initial claims about kava having any sort of adverse liver effects, I don't believe them to be particularly worrisome. If I did, I wouldn't use kava at all. It wouldn't be worth the risk to my health. There's other supplements that work. But from what I've seen and from my own personal experiences, I don't believe this to be the case. Like I said, talk to your doctor or, you know, see how you feel as you take it. If something feels off, if something feels doesn't right, discontinue use of it. But I don't really believe that there's a lot of credibility to any sort of claim that kava would be harmful to the body or to the liver, just from what I've seen online and from what I've experienced myself. With that said, it's important to remember not to overdo it. Don't go crazy. This is a natural sort of supplement, a plant. However, everything in moderation. Don't be excessive with it. Just like alcohol, you can't consume this every day, where it's going to have some real bad effects on your body, for sure. With that said, I would also completely avoid mixing kava with any sort of alcohol or other anti-anxiety medications, because that can have extremely bad effects. Anytime anybody talks online about drinking kava and drinking alcohol in the same day, they end up feeling very sick, nauseous, just all the worst side effects that you really want to avoid. So do not combine those things. Keep them separate. I would even keep a day in between personally, just to be safe. That's how I would do it. But like I said, don't consume kava and alcohol at the same time, or any other sort of anti-anxiety drugs. And if you have any questions, anything like that, talk to your doctor about it and make sure it is safe before doing so. If you are looking to try kava for the first time, or to buy it somewhere or anything like that, I do have a few recommendations for you guys. My very first recommendation is just to go to a kava bar near you. Look it up on Google Maps or something like that and find out where you can get to a nearby kava bar. A lot of most major cities are gonna have something nearby if you plug it into Google Maps. If you're in some sort of isolated or rural area, you might not have a kava bar near you and you might need to use one of my later suggestions. But if you're in a big city or even a mid-sized city, you're probably gonna have multiple kava bars within driving distance. So check it out, because it's a really cool cultural environment. Going in there, it's just relaxing. It's sort of like somewhere in between a bar and a cafe, and it's just a really cool vibe. It's also an awesome first date spot, because I mean, anyone you take to this spot is on a first date or whatever date. Most of them are gonna have their minds blown, that there's the way that mine was the first time I found out about kava bars. Most people are gonna have their minds blown, like, whoa, there is a plant that we can drink and get intoxicated right down the road from us that I never even knew this plant existed. It's an awesome first date spot. So definitely try kava at a kava bar if you can, especially because the bartender can just walk you through the whole ritual and the process. It feels really authentic and fun. If you can't do that, you can always buy a kava shaker bottle online and buy kava powder yourself. So there's some really cool shaker bottles, sort of like protein shakers, that are now sold online. I will link to my favorite one below, or if you're watching this on YouTube, you can hop over to the full article that I have correlating. I'll link to that below as well, for, you know, finding the best kava for anxiety. And like I said, they have shaker bottles for kava that kind of have like a strainer ball that you put the kava powder inside, and then you put it into the sort of like a protein shaker. It's an awesome investment, especially if you're going to drink kava for any extended period of time, because you can just make the kava shakes right at home. They can also be a little expensive at the bar. Like I said, go to the bar first, just because it's such an authentic, cool experience. But you know, if you decide you like kava, it's a little bit more cost effective, just like buying a six pack and drinking that at your home or pre-gaming before going to the bars. It's the same sort of deal. You know, the shaker bottle is a lot more cost effective. So I would definitely recommend anybody who likes kava to check that out. And the other method, if you don't really, if you can't stand drinking kava, or you just want something a little bit more discreet or convenient, there's actually kava candy that sort of masks the flavor of kava. I don't think it's as strong as a kava drink, just because it's so small and concentrated, but they're pretty good and they're pretty discreet. And even if like you have anxiety in the workplace or something like that, it's pretty easy to just take out this little package of candy, basically, and you can just have one. It'll be a quick, natural way to relieve some of your stress and symptoms of anxiety and stuff like that. So kava candy is also a good route to go. Like I said, first try the kava bar, then I would, if you like it, invest in a kava shaker bottle. And also, if you're trying to just be a little bit more discreet with it, then the kava candy is a great option for you. I will link below this video or in the main article to my personal kava recommendations for the best source for kava powder, kava shaker bottle, kava candy, stuff like that. That way you guys can be drinking or taking kava the same way that I currently am. So check out those links. Also, guys, I wanted to tell you a few times that I would personally recommend kava use, because once you kind of have an idea of how it works for you, you might be wondering what situations it's good for. I sort of recommend kava for any sort of mild or moderate anxiety relief, or anytime you just need to take the edge off of your stress or anything like that. Kava is going to work different for every person, and anxiety is a very subjective thing. So I don't have a blanket recommendation for everybody, but I think that kava can be great for any time where you want to be just a little bit more social and a little bit less anxious. So sort of like other supplements I recommend, like fenibut and stuff like that. This is more mild. It's natural, which is great, because I think that it's safer to take it more often than more powerful supplements like fenibut or anti-anxiety medications or things like that. But it's somewhere in the moderate scale of anxiety solutions. It's somewhere right around with alcohol. So anything that alcohol might feel good to take to decrease your anxiety, this is sort of right around that ballpark to make you feel a little bit more social, but also a little bit more like laid back, go with the flow, euphoric, and just having a good time. So anytime you need that little edge on your anxiety, this might be a really good solution for you. But you guys try it out for yourself. That's all I have for you today about kava. Try it out. Let me know what situations it helps you in. Tell me, you know, does kava work for you your first time? Did it take you a couple of tries before it really hit that flow and it actually helped you to decrease your anxiety and feel the full effects? And just let me know, what situations do you guys use kava in, and how do you like it? I hope to hear from you guys soon. Thank you so much for sticking to the end. I will see you next time.